Okay, let's do the same for the female figure, starting with the front view. We draw the torso in a bean shape, but this time with a smooth angle, more of a spherical bean than a box one. Then we add the ribcage opening, the gesture line, the clavicles and the shoulders. The breast here instead of the chest muscles, and finally the navel. After that, we draw the opening of the pelvis and the pubic lines. Now we can add the arms in dynamic shapes. The legs afterward in dynamic shapes. And now we can do the same for the other side. Finally, we add the head. We can now fix any mistakes, then move on to the detail. Make sure you check the proportions at the landmark video for the figure before you start drawing, so you know where and what to draw when you're doing this exercise. After the initial details, we are now done, and we can add another layer of line weight on top and finish up the drawing. And here is the final drawing with the framework underneath it side by side. Now let's move on to the back view. For the back view, we have a different set of landmarks to look for, like the medial spinal line, the sacrum, the gluteus fold, the scapula with the shoulders joint, and the ribcage bottom. Now we can draw the neck and the head. We move on to the arms. And finally, the legs. Now we move on to the details. Let's zoom in once more, lower the opacity, and add a final layer of details on top. And here it is, both views with the dynamic shape framework side by side. So let's do the other two views in the next video.